Hello guys and welcome to TechWolf, and today we will be talking about trading techniques. If you are new to this channel, then all my playlists with all tutorials and all other videos are available on my channel's homepage. If you go to my channel's homepage, here you will see all playlists. And this video will be continuation on trading tutorial for beginners. As you can see here guys, currently we have already there 5 videos, and in last video we covered what is TradingView and how you can get your head around with TradingView. What are available trading techniques and what you can use for trading? First trading technique is scalp trading. Scalpers, they are traders who are using scalp trading. They are known as scalpers. They can take trades in seconds, or they can their trades can last even minutes. Taking trade means that they are pressing that button buy. When they close positions, they can press button sell. If you are using leverage trading, you can make money both ways. If market goes up, you can buy, for example, and you can make profits. This means that you are buying low and selling high. And if market goes down, you can sell or short market. This means that if you think that market will be going down, guys, you are selling on top and you are buying back in the lowest part. But about leverage trading and about futures trading and CFDs and all other things in more detail we will talk in next videos. But in this video, let's keep to the plan and only to trading techniques. So first trading technique is scalping. This means that traders take trades very fast. In during one day, they can take multiple trades. Each time scalper enters and exits market, this means each time he buys, for example, stock, or he buys some pair and he goes out of that pair, for example, currency pair, because scalping is very popular in forex markets for foreign exchange on different currency pairs. So scalping trading is very popular if you are doing leverage trading, because you can take a huge positions in cryptocurrency. Recently, leverage trading and scalping is very popular. Bad sides of scalp trading is that every time you are taking trade or you are leaving trade, is that every time you are paying fees. You are paying some fees. It is a difference between entry price and exit price, and you have to be profitable to do scalp trading. And scalp trading is very stressful, guys. You might think that you might keep it. If you haven't traded, guys, you might think that you would be able to keep up with scalp trading and you could become a scalper. But I promise you guys that this is very, very stressful trading, and only some people out there can do scalp trading. Me myself, I also have been trying doing scalp trading, but this is too stressful. It takes too much time, and to do scalp trading you have to learn how to control your emotions, and some people can't even do it when they are doing day trading. And day trading is second technique of trading, which means that you are taking trades every day. You are not doing multiple trades. You might do only one trade in one day, or for example in 2 days. It depends on price movement, but you would be looking at much bigger frame. Currently on the screen we are viewing TradingView, and currently I have a time frame, as you remember from my previous video. And if you haven't watched my previous video, then go check out my previous video. I am at 1 minute time frame. This means every candle in this chart represents 1 minute. And if you would be doing day trading, then you wouldn't be looking at these charts. You would be looking at 5 minute chart. This is the smallest. Or you would be looking at 1 hour chart, or some bigger 1 hour chart, 4 hour chart, and so on and so forth to do your trading. And then you are looking for patterns in charts. We will talk about what is patterns as well. But main thing here is to understand, guys, that day traders can trade only one trade a day, or even one trade in 2 days, or even in some cases 3 days or 4 days. And I'm telling you this from experience, guys, that you might not find a trade every single day. Price, for example, could be consolidating and you wouldn't know where it will go. Well, whether it will break out to the upside or whether it will break out to the downside. And patterns also would be unclear. So as indicators wouldn't give you a good understanding about price. And we talked already, or started talking, about what is indicators. And here is one indicator, RSI indicator, relative strength indicator at the bottom. And like I mentioned, guys, in all my tutorials, once you will watch them, you will know everything about trading. And we will talk about patterns, about charm patterns, what they are drawing and how you can spot different patterns to take trades or exit trades, and we will talk also about indicators and how you can take trades or exit trades by watching indicators. And here currently what we are seeing, for example, if we are looking at 1 hour chart, in indicator, RSI indicator is telling that the particular asset, in this case which is Bitcoin, is being oversold. This means that sooner or later this price will have to turn back up and it will have to start going back up, guys. However, this indicator could go much lower if we, for example, scroll here and look longer term. You can see that this price here, for example, it has been dropping much lower. But like I said, guys, we will talk about indicators. So first one is scalp trading, second one is day trading, and next one is swing trading. And swing traders usually don't look at any hour charts. What charts they are looking at is 1 week chart, 1 day charts. Then they have a clearer picture of what is going on and they are trending swings. If you look at RSI indicators, then you see when RSI indicator here, for example, is at the very bottom, then price is at the very bottom. This means that this could be a good time to buy, right, for swing trader, because he knows that this price or this asset is oversold, and he would buy here approximately when price is oversold, and then he would be waiting until price would start going up, and which you can clearly see here that this RSI indicator after goes up, so as price goes up, and then at the top, when price has reached the top levels of RSI, which are 70 usually or 80, guys, then swing traders are usually selling, and that's the way how they are making profits. They are making profits on these swings, but not only on day charts. They also use week. They also can use weekly charts. For example, this would be another chart. Here we also see the same pattern on the chart. When the price is at the very lower points, we can see that RSI indicator or relative strength indicator is at the very lowest point. And then when the price starts going up, we can see that RSI is also going up. And usually swing trader would be selling here about 70. Because you can't predict how much more this price will go up or how much lower it will go. So you are exiting your trade approximately here if you are a swing trader. Then you are waiting when the price will go up, or you, for example, shorting, and this means that you are making profit when the price is going up because you are seeing that market is oversold or particular asset is oversold. So this is about swing trading. And next and last, fourth position is position trading, and fourth technique is position trading. And position trading means that you are not looking at small charts. You will never look. If you would be a position trader, you would be thinking about long-term investments, which are weeks, months, and even years, guys. So that's what would be position trading. This is very similar to investing, because you will notice, guys, that I haven't mentioned investing in talking about trading techniques, because, guys, investing is not trading. Investor, for example, you or me, we could be investors, but we might not have a knowledge in trading, in reading charts, because many people who are investing, they have some company, like for example Tesla or Apple, they might want to invest in that company, and they would be investors just because they can't read charts and they can't understand how charts work, and they are investing only in believing in that company, guys, and they think that this price will go up because Tesla, for example, is producing very good cars, and that person who is investor and investing, he believes in idea, and he is investing exactly because of that reason, that he believes in company. But he is not a trading, and that is not considered a position trading just because of that reason, guys, that he is not able to read a charts. But he is investor, and that's why investing is not a technique of trading. So guys, in trading we have 4 trading techniques. First one is scalping, second one is day trading, the third one is swing trading, and fourth one is position trading. And then we have investors, those guys who doesn't understand anything in charting. So yes, guys, I hope that you found this video useful. If you did, leave a like, share this video, subscribe to my channel if you're new, and see you in the next one.
Then check this out.